Now that is about this thing. Now let us see about other things which are various balance. I'll take few personal accounts, examples of few personal accounts which generally show debit or credit balance. Under personal accounts, I am taking loan, I am taking let us say debtors, creditors. Debtors, creditors. Now this loan, if you nothing is given, we always assume it is loan taken, and it loan taken is we have to repay. Anything we have to repay is a liability. So loan shows credit balance. Then loan given shows debit balance. You have to be very specific. If you, the business gave loan to someone, we say loan to so and so person or loan given. So that shows debit balance because you have to get the money back. Now next, debtors. Hidden in the word debtors is D, so it shows debit balance. Who are debtors? Debtors are the customers who have purchased from you goods on credit. On a particular date, when you are preparing or closing your ledgers, the customers who have not yet paid you the money, put together all the names of the customers. Suppose let us say Amar has to give you 2000, Ajay has to give you 3000, some X has to give you 5000. So such people, several customers on a particular date who have to give you money, if all the amounts due to them are total, then they are referred with one common name called debtors. So debtors are nothing but they are the customers who have to still give you money for the goods purchased by them from you. Now opposite is creditors. Suppose you have purchased, let us say, from 10 different people. To some people you have paid, but on the date of closing the ledgers, to some suppliers you have not yet paid the money. So all the suppliers to whom you did not pay money, the amounts payable to them total is called creditors. So the name itself has the word credit. So creditors show credit balance. Apart from this, some you can say coming to nominal accounts, you see the rule is very simple. If you see an expense, you should automatically say it shows debit balance. Similarly, if you see incomes, you should automatically say they show credit balance. How to understand whether it is income or not? Sometimes when you have, for example, rent, simply given becomes an expense. But if it is given, rent received, so the word received makes it income, and therefore rent received shows credit balance, rent or rent paid shows debit balance. I am repeating, if it is not given, whether it is paid or received, we assume rent is paid. We assume rent or rent paid are one and the same and treat it as an expense. Now next, after nominal accounts, let us see further few advanced level personal accounts which are very rare, or rather you have not come across in your basic journal entries. Some examples are any outstanding expense. Now what is an outstanding expense? Outstanding expense means, for example, you will understand this better through a journal entry. For example, I paid salary to my workers. What journal entry we write? Let us say salary account debit to cash. I have to pay him 12 months salary. I paid him 10 months salary. So at the end of the year, this salary should be debited for 12 months. Let us assume salary is 1000 per month. So, that means the total amount I should pay as salary to my employer, employee is how much? 12,000. So, my total salary expense is 12,000. So, debit all expenses. I paid to him 10,000. So, cash going out is 10,000. So, still I have to pay 2,000. That 2,000 is called outstanding salary. Outstanding salary. So, therefore, outstanding salary is coming under the category of personal account because I owe this amount to a person. So, we don't write the name of that person, but we say the purpose for which we have to pay to that person, we state and add the word outstanding, making it a representative personal account. So, outstanding expenses come under the category of personal account. Similarly, opposite, outstanding incomes. Outstanding incomes. So, they show debit balance, opposite, okay, because income is opposite of expense. Similarly, when expense shows debit balance, income shows credit balance. So, outstanding expense is showing credit balance means outstanding income shows debit balance. Now, further, we have in this category prepaid expenses, and you also have income received in advance. Now, what is prepaid expense? Prepaid expense is opposite of outstanding expense, meaning suppose to one employee I have to pay, let us assume I have three employees. I have three employees. So, our year is 2000, let us assume 16. For 2016, I have to pay salary to my three employees. Let us say on 31st December, for employee 1, I pay, each employee gets 1000. Each employee gets, let us assume 1000. That means, employee 1, how much I should pay? 12,000. Employee 2, I must pay 12,000. Employee 3, I must pay 12,000. So, if we analyze, let us assume this is his salary. So, I gave him cash 12,000. Now, here in this case, I paid only 10,000. Now, here in this case, I have paid him, let us say 14,000. Let us assume this employee came to us with a request. He came to us with a request that he needs some cash, and later on we cut from his salary or adjust from his salary, whatever it is. Now, if we see the journalizing part, the total salary here comes to 36,000 for the year 2016. Now, when we see the paid amount, how much did we pay here in this case? We have 0. Whatever is salary, we paid that much. Let us assume here 2000 is payable. 2000 is payable. And here if you see, 2000 is extra payment, what you gave, extra amount paid. So, I will just call extra payment. Now, what is the paid amount if you see here? 36,000 still. But you have something extra which is 4,000. Now, how to journalize this part? When I journalize this part, my salary account debit will be 36,000. Salary account debit 36,000. I have paid cash. So, cash is also 36,000. No doubt both are equal, but at the same time, I have salary payable, which is nothing but outstanding expense. Just now we discussed what is outstanding expense. So, I am going to put my outstanding expense in the credit part, making it 2000. Then coming to, for example, we know that debits should be equal to credit. Here if we see, we have debit 36 and credit 38. Now what about the remaining two? It's an extra payment paid. So that is what we call it as prepaid salary. We call it as prepaid salary. So since we are debiting, you should understand that is how prepaid expenses show debit balance. Then coming to one more thing under this thing, you should have income received in advance. Income received in advance, it is an income which you have, let us say, you have received not only this year's income, you received next year's income also. Example would be, for example, if you have a room and you have given it on rent, let us say your tenant gave you the rent for 2016, and which is, let us assume, is our current year, and also he gave you 2017's rent also. So whatever he gave for next year is called as income received in advance for you. So income received in advance of a different year other than current year is a liability. It shows credit balance. All these four are called as your representative personal accounts. They are called as your representative personal accounts. No. So, if we see, outstanding expense shows credit balance, outstanding income shows debit balance, prepaid expense shows debit balance, income received in advance shows your credit balance. So, till here, I think it is clear. Now, let us move on to further and see. Few extra things which we have not come across. For example, you have your subsidiary books. You have your subsidiary books. Based on the subsidiary books, we will see how you can remember some balances. Generally, you say you have cash book already we dealt. So let us see. For example, you have purchase book. Purchases book. So I'm cut. Then you have sales book. Then you have purchase returns.